My name is Joel Hartenberger. I'm an engineer here at Carderock in Code 853, which is the resistance and powering branch. We do experimental hydrodynamics projects. What you see behind me is actually the test article for one of those projects. This is the HIFOIL, the high Reynolds number hydrofoil. And what we're doing with this test article is installing different materials into it. And then we're going to put it into Carderock's Large Cavitation Channel, which is the world's largest water tunnel. And it'll allow us to run high speeds and create cavitating flow, which is when your flow turns from water to vapor. And this is a common problem for Navy platforms where the cavitation can actually damage or erode your material over time. And the goal of this project is to get data at conditions that are very similar to what you might experience at full scale, but in a well-controlled environment, which is not something you can really have at full scale. So it's this unique capability that Carderock has, and it truly is unique. With this test article and that facility, we're gonna get data that's never been gotten before. And it's gonna allow us to link small scale evaluation experiments that can be done in a laboratory in just a benchtop setting, and try to link those data to what we see at full scale when we do inspections of rudders and propellers and stuff like that. The HIFOIL is sitting here on this machine, the Doosan, at Carderock and Building 9. We needed to have some pockets machined out of it to install our test materials. And even though the foil existed from an earlier project, it was built in the late 1990s, but we repurposed it as a test bed for our project. Really, without Building 9, we couldn't have done this, because you can see it's a large piece. It's 10 feet wide, it's 7 feet tall, it weighs 15,000 pounds roughly. And to be able to machine these pockets into it requires a very special sort of machine. And we're actually using the full capability of this machine. It can handle 30,000 pounds, and the bed can move 8 feet by 13 feet by 2 feet. And that gives us just enough room to do the machine work we need to do. And it's worth mentioning that this was a quick turnaround, right? So we could have perhaps found outside companies that could have done this work, but not in the timeline we needed it. And I'm very grateful to Carderock's team for helping us get this completed to stay on budget, which is a high priority for our sponsor. And it's not just Building 9. We're also working with Carderock machinists down in Building 4E, with the LCC machinists, and they've been fantastic, helping us get a lot of our parts on schedule, which simply would not have been possible without them. So it's been a fantastic learning experience for me as a relatively new engineer, seeing the capabilities we have, and supporting an important Navy project. And that's really what Carderock has. You know, working with the universities, you can see they have fantastic people, very smart people that can help give us ideas about fundamental physics that inform our Navy designs. However, what they don't have are large facilities where they can go and evaluate those theories and see if they're correct. And that's really the power of Carderock. We have these sorts of capabilities, and we have the world's largest water tunnel, and those are what allow us to answer questions that people can theorize about at universities, and then we can create new technologies for the Navy that are going to enable us to maintain our edge above our competitors, our adversaries, and our peers.